Great news, you finally have a job. And so you've been handed this W-4 form to fill out. You have a big worksheet up here that you start working on and get very confused. And then you have the W-4 down here. Now, the first thing I'm going to caution you is that I am not an accountant and I'm not in payroll. I'm an economics teacher doing this for a project. So use this information with a grain of salt and a little bit of caution because nothing bad is going to happen to my students if they fill it out wrong, but you could end up owing the IRS a good bit of money if you do it incorrectly. So talk to your personnel department, talk to your human resources person. Another thing I'll tell you is if you have a bad year, and end up paying a good bit to the IRS, or you have a small refund and would like to see one higher, you can always go back and revise this form with your personnel department. So just file another W-4, have them enter it into their payroll program, and you can restart and hopefully correct any mistakes you made last year. So here for the W-4, you're going to do the obvious and fill out your name, your Social Security number for your employer, of course, not for my project. Your address, and then you come to the part that's going to affect your taxes. You're going to check single or married, and then there's the married but withhold at higher single rate. So, for example, if you have a spouse that makes a great deal more than you do, you might want to choose that married but withhold at higher single rate. I'm talking 2 to 3 times your salary, and your town and zip code. Finally, your allowances. So the whole idea of withholdings is that this form tells your employer what to put into their payroll, and they're going to look up how much taxes they should withhold monthly for you so that hopefully at the end of the year you don't get very much back from the IRS and you certainly don't owe any taxes. The lower this number is, the more taxes will be withheld from your paycheck, and the more likely you are to get a refund or the larger your refund will be. The higher this number on line 5 is, the fewer taxes will be withheld, and the less likely you are to get a refund or the smaller your refund will be. If you get this number too high, you may end up owing the IRS. So this is a number you want to be careful with, particularly if you're entering into incomes in the $45,000 and above range for both you and your spouse. You may want to take a look at this, talk with personnel. But for you in your regular life, first job as a teenager, I would mark myself single, put 0 for this. That's going to be maximum withholdings. That would maximize your refund and go on about your life. That comes from this personal allowances worksheet, and you would be entering one here on line B. Because you're a dependent of your parents in your real life, you would enter 0 here. And so you could be S0, meaning that you're not taking any allowances, even though you have the option, or S1, which means that you're getting more in your monthly paycheck, but you're not going to get as big of a refund. In the life of our project, we want to maximize our monthly withholdings. So your goal here is to get a number that's high enough to not get a very big refund, but of course not owe the IRS at the end of the year. So you're going to put the number of allowances that make sense for you. If you're single, we didn't have children in our project, so you would enter one for yourself because no one is going to claim you on their taxes. You don't live with your parents anymore. And you might enter one here on line B, which will give you an S2 withholding. The rest of this information, if you don't have children, is not relevant to you. The one mistake I see students make is they often say, "Hey, I'm the head of my household. I'm single." Well, the idea with head of household is that you are taking on other household members, perhaps an elderly or disabled family member, perhaps children where you're not receiving a lot of child support or you've been widowed. And since that doesn't fit anyone in our project, you're not going to be marking yourself head of household. For a married couple, you're going to mark married, and then you would claim yourself and any children that you have here on line D. It's not typically a good idea to enter a one here for your spouse on line C because you probably want a little more tax withheld just to avoid having to pay the taxes man at the end of the year. If you are married and have a homemaker as a spouse, then you would claim your spouse as well. So the general rule of thumb is you claim yourself and any children here on line 5. So that number will range from 1, claiming yourself, to any children you have, which will be as high as 3. You can go as low as 0 to maximize your refund, but again, for our project purposes, not a good idea. Hope this helps.